I'm Julie Goodnight, and I'm here today to talk to you about the Myler three-ring combination bit. We're going to do a little bit of an unboxing here. I have two three-ring combination bits, one more I would think of for an English horse, one more for a Western horse. So we're going to unbox them. I want to show you a few things about the bits, and in particular how to attach them to both the English and the Western head stall. So first of all, when you order the three-ring combination, if you order it from an online retailer, it's probably going to come in a little bag, a Ziploc bag. If you walk into a tack room and or tack store and buy it, you're probably going to buy it off a rack and it'll be out of the bag, but it should be hanging up in an orderly fashion. So if you ordered it from an online retailer or it came in a bag, then it was probably placed into the bag in an orderly and neat fashion. So as you open the bag and bring that bit out, slide it out. Try not to get it all tangled up as you slide it out. There's a lot of moving parts to these bits, and it's not hard for them to get messed up and tangled up if you drop them or handle them carelessly. So nothing's going to fall apart, by the way. You can't break it or anything. It'll just get tangled up and be hard to get organized again. So I slid the bit out just like this, and you can see that it's folded up neatly, and so it came out just like it would hang on the horse. And so if I can, whether you buy it in the tack store and you take it off the rack or you pull it out of a bag, try to keep the bit in order, because once it's tangled up, it's a challenge to fix. So what can happen, I'll show you the alternative, is if I just sort of jumble this bit around and I drop it a couple of times and pick it back up, pretty soon it's just this jumbled, tangled mess. And it's gonna, if you're not familiar with this bit already, it's gonna be really hard to get it back to the place it needs to be. So since I am familiar with the bits, hopefully I can get this righted, get this ship righted. And I'll show you how it should look if it's correct, and that way you'll be able to hopefully get it back together if it's tangled up. So you'll see the three rings on the side. This is why it's called the three-ring combination. So the rings point down, and this single ring up here on the is the top part of the bit. This is the purchase of the bit. This is the piece that your head stall attaches to. So the flat strap of the noseband goes in front. The noseband is actually integrated into the bit. It doesn't come off of the bit unless you're changing it out with a new noseband, but for the most part, it's going to come on the bit. You're going to leave it on the bit and never take it off. So when it sits on the horse's head like so, kind of get around, give you the 360 here. So these two rings on the top is where the head stall attaches. You'll notice if you're having trouble figuring out which way the bit goes, the mouthpiece of the bit is always shaped sort of in a little bit of an arc like the horse's mouth is. Also, you'll see the side of the bit that goes against the tongue of the horse has little tiny copper inlays in here. That is the surface that lays against the tongue. That's the only place where those inlays are. And then the guides for the noseband always stick to the outside away from the horse. So all of these things are going to help you to determine which is the correct way the horse, the bit will hang on the head stall. Now, when you unpackage the bit, it'll have a little tag here. This one says level 3. That means that this mouthpiece, this tag is an indicator that this mouthpiece is for a horse that has a fair amount of training, not for a green horse. That's what the level 3 refers to. Also, you'll see this rather large tag attached to the bit. Obviously, we're going to remove that before we put it on the horse. But I always tell people to make sure you hang on to this tag for a couple of reasons. One is it identifies the exact bit that you got, the size of it, the mouthpiece, and everything. So often people aren't sure what the name of their bit was. It's a good idea to keep a record of this. Second of all, and most importantly, look at all the information in this one little brochure. It's one little tag is actually a brochure on the bit that has all kinds of instructions about how the bit works, why you use it, how you adjust it. So not only is it good to hang on to this, but it's a good idea to actually read it. So I've got the bit out now. I've got it unpacked. I've got it organized. Sometimes people are curious about the weight of this bit. I don't think of it as a particularly heavy bit, but sometimes people do. Heavier is good in a bit. A heavier bit is steady and stable in the horse's mouth. Also, keep in mind it's hanging off the head stall, so it's not hopefully not hanging on his mouth that much weight. So I don't think of this as a particularly heavy bit, but it's maybe because of the weight of the nose band on there that people are remarking on that. So the nose band is going to go around the chin. It comes with this nice little hook on there. So once I have appropriately adjusted the chin strap to the individual horse, now all I have to do is fasten that hook. So this is what it's going to look like once it's hanging on the head stall and on the horse's head. So we got the bit organized now. When I'm putting any kind of bridle together, I always like the bridle hanging neatly. And so it's facing one direction so that as I set up the bit, I can make sure everything's facing the same direction and correct for the horse. Now, we're going to put this particular bit, which is, you'll notice it has a black leather nose band. This particular bit is quite popular for English horses, the open jumpers, the cross-country jumpers, horses like that. And so we're going to put it on an English head stall. Now, this is just a typical English head stall with a cavesson. So I'm just going to remove the cavesson because we don't need it with the three-ring combination. Because the bit actually has a nose band incorporated into the bit. All right, so I'll just take the cavesson off. And also with any head stall for the three ring combination, generally we're going to want a little smaller head stall than normal. So the three ring combination has a tall purchase, so the purchase of the bit is that part that is above the mouthpiece, and because it's quite tall above the mouthpiece, your cheek pieces are going to need to be a little bit shorter. This particular English bridle was actually cut down to fit an Arabian, so I find that works really well on a regular size horse with the three ring combination. So I've got my bit organized the way it's going to sit on the head of the horse. I've got my head stall organized facing in the same direction. So I'm just going to first attach the head stall on each side. And I just want to constantly, as I'm setting this up, I'm constantly picturing everything as it sits on the horse. I've got things hanging the way they would hang on the horse. And it's just good horsemanship to always keep your equipment that way anyway, because it's going to stay in better shape for you. So there's the three ring combination then hanging on an English head stall with the nose band fastened. So the only thing we're lacking now is the reins. So I'll hang my head stall back here. Here's a plain old set of English reins. And you'll notice that the reason why we call it the three ring combination is we have three rings on the side piece of the bit. Notice that the rings point down. And we're going to attach the rein to either the middle or the bottom ring, and not the top ring. The top ring is going to sort of defeat the design of the bit. If we attach the reins here, it just simply acts like a regular old snaffle, and we don't want that. So we're going to attach the reins. I like to start with the reins attached in the middle ring, And so I'm going to just attach the reins to the middle rings of the bit. And attaching to the middle rings is generally where I like to start with any horse. And what that does is straighten out my, take the twist out of my reins, go to the middle ring on the off side here. Now we've got the three ring combination with the reins attached. And as I said, I like to start with them on the middle configuration. This is going to mean that the horse feels nose pressure, then pull pressure, followed by chin pressure. And he will not feel the mouth pressure until you pull back the rein far enough to where this stopper engages right here. Once that stopper engages, then the horse feels mouth pressure. So generally, I'm going to start with any horse I'm introducing this to riding on the middle ring, see how the horse responds there. If at any time I feel like I don't have enough stopping power on the horse, he's a little bit too strong on me, I can drop it down to the lower ring, and then I have more curbing action for the horse. So that's what it's going to look like on the English bridle.